E3 is now come and gone, with Microsoft ending its media briefing by revealing the first in-game cutscene that will serve as the opening to Halo Infinite. And boy, does it give us all sorts of hints and clues as to what we can expect to see in the game when it releases next year. Here are some of those teasers to look forward to in Master Chief's long-awaited return. The immediate thing we all have to recognise is that Chief is back in a somewhat familiar looking armour, but hold your horses, this isn't exactly an old armour per se, it's technically something new, but it has a lot of throwbacks to all manner of past armours sported by our favourite Spartan. How do we know it's new? Well, when Chief's armour starts rebooting thanks to Echo 216, the mysterious new pilot who we'll chat more about later, we see all sorts of information pop up in the BIOS. One of the key things to take away from the boot up is that the new armour was built in 2559, a year after the events of Halo 5 Guardians. On top of that, the BIOS also shows that Dr. Catherine Halsey modified the armour 2 years later in 2561. Now, as for the armor itself, this actually features all kinds of references to different armors from not just the games, but from the live action and animated films too. The first notable new addition to the armor is the number 117 plastered onto the chest plate. This is actually taken straight from the Halo Legends animated short The Package and the live action film Halo Forward Unto Dawn. The majority of the armor and the helmet design, however, is mostly cherry-picked from Halo 3, but the overall bulkiness of it is actually lifted from Halo 4 and 5, so there are some hints of the design's feature in previous Halo titles developed by 343. All in all, despite being very familiar, this is actually a completely new set of Mjolnir armor. Now, going back to that boot up BIOS and Chief's armor, there's actually a bunch of interesting tidbits to take away from this. As the system cycles through all its armor checks and whatnot, we quickly see the acronym SPDR rush by, which stands for System Peril Distributed Reflex, which originally came from the popular Halo 2 ARG marketing campaign I Love Bees. In the wider lore of the Halo universe, the SPDR system is actually something that's used to repair damaged AIs that are too damaged to repair themselves or are suffering from rampancy, which is basically when an AI goes a little bit crazy. With that bit of context thrown in, we can now take away from this that Chief's new armor is actually built to repair AIs that might go rampant. You know, kind of like Cortana did in Halo 4 and 5, which turned her into this big old baddie trying to take over the whole galaxy. In all probability, we'll likely have to fight her in Halo Infinite. And perhaps with Chief's new armor, we might see Cortana getting repaired from her rampancy. But you're probably wondering how on earth Chief would capture her. Well, after Chief's new armor is all booted up, he then goes to look at an AI chip that he had gripped in his hand. Now, when you freeze this shot, flip it around and enhance it, you'll be able to make out the serial number, which is CTN0453-0. Now, if you're already a hardcore Halo fan, then this will immediately start ringing some bells. For those of you who aren't, though, this new chip is essentially one iteration higher than Cortana's old chip, which was CTN0452-9. So slowly the pieces are starting to come together. Now we know that this new chip has been designed with Cortana in mind, and also know that Chief's suit is designed to repair damaged AI. And as to how he'll actually capture her, well, when he inserts the chip into his suit, the BIOS pops up saying weapon containment device inserted. So this chip isn't just any old standard usual AI chip, but it looks as though it's something that was designed to perhaps capture Cortana so that Chief can put her into his new system and let the SPDR try and fix her. But enough about the Chief, there's so much more to this new trailer than John and Cortana. One of those things is the new pilot that we're introduced to, Echo 216. Unfortunately, we don't have an official name for him as of yet, barring his call sign. All we know is that he's a UNSC soldier and a father. Although Halo Infinite will focus on the Master Chief, unlike Halo 5 Guardians, which mainly focused on Spartan Locke and Fireteam Osiris, players can still expect to come across various new characters just like Echo 216, who we were introduced to in the new trailer. The blog post on Halo Waypoint explains that there will be a few new important characters that we'll meet that will play key roles in Halo Infinite's narrative. So, much like Sergeant Johnson, Miranda Keys, and the Arbiter from the original Halo trilogy, we can expect to see some newer faces filling in those roles. Hopefully, though, we'll still see the Arbiter making a return and having a more prominent place in the story too. Now onto the next juicy part of the new trailer, the destroyed Halo ring. Ever since the Slipspace engine demo from last year's E3, players have been speculating that this new ring is actually Installation 07, also known as Zeta Halo. This was one of the original 7 existing Halo rings and one of the only surviving installations from the original 12. During the Forerunner Flood War, this ring was stolen by 032 Mendicant Bias, a Forerunner AI that went rampant much like Cortana. After Mendicant Bias was defeated, the Forerunners sent this ring through a portal with the presumably Flood-infected Forerunners. It was then activated to eradicate all sentient life in the galaxy with the other 6 installations in order to contain the Flood. Since then, the ring has been floating idly in space. In the first Halo Infinite announcement trailer, this ring was teased through a handheld radio that was playing a Morse code, which roughly translated to SOS Zeta Halo Grid, or GRD, whatever you want to take away from that. In this new trailer, if you look carefully at the radar and the dashboard of the Pelican when Echo 216 attempts to make contact with the friendly signal and do a cheeky zoom in, you'll see, albeit slightly blurry, that the text says Local Ref Zeta. It looks like we now have a location for where Halo Infinite could take place. Now, there are multiple Halo channels out there that are currently posting all sorts of speculative theories into how Zeta Halo could have been destroyed. Some believe that the UNSC Infinity may have set a course straight for the ring to destroy it in order to prevent another force from being able to use it. Alternatively, Cortana might have used the Guardian from Halo 5 in order to stop the UNSC from getting their hands on it to possibly put an end to her insane plan. There's a lot of differing theories, but sadly, the trailer doesn't offer any glimpses of what could be the culprit. However, towards the end of the Infinite E3 trailer, we see Chief walking towards the center of a Halo control room, which is a near enough one-to-one replica of the control room scene from Halo Combat Evolved. While performing his super dramatic stroll, we can see a hologram of Zeta Halo being destroyed, and when you slow it down, you can make out that there are 2 different impact points. One initial impact point towards the left, and then another big one towards the center, which actually shatters the ring. Whatever happened, Zeta Halo's destruction wasn't brought about by a singular cause, but rather multiple. Unfortunately, we're going to have to wait a little longer to find out what exactly caused it, though. Those are some of the things that you might have missed from the Halo Infinite E3 2019 trailer. If there's any other tidbits that you think you spotted, let us know in the comments down below. And like always, don't forget to like and subscribe to the Rosera Network. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.